Oh, hi friends. Happy Friday. Well, I'm gonna try to make this video as fun as possible today, and this will be a decorate with me in a room that I typically don't share. Stay tuned. So let me ask you guys a question. Does seasonal decorating have to be confined to the main living areas of your home? The answer is no. You don't have to keep your seasonal decorating confined to just your main living areas or just a room here and there. You can actually sprinkle seasonal decor wherever it makes your eyes happy. There are no rules. You can do what you want in your own home. So I thought to myself, why not bring a little Easter up here in the master bedroom? We hang out here at night before we go off into slumberland, and we often watch the news or a movie, and I thought, we've got this cozy little table over here, and last night I kept staring at it. I kept looking at it going, you're so pathetic. We need to jazz you up for Easter, and that's that. I'm gonna do it. So here I am. So in today's video, we're going to talk about how to add a focal point on a table and build your vignette around it. We're gonna talk about how to illuminate your vignettes to give them light and make them feel fresh and bright and pretty. And let's see what else. And then we're gonna talk about adding texture, and all of those combined will make a beautiful arrangement. So let's get started, let's do this. All right, friends, this is what we're gonna start with. This table you see here is from Pier 1 Imports. I believe I got it roughly 4 years ago. And I really debated on whether or not to paint it. But you know what, I've got to tell you, I am starting to see blacks come back, darker woods mixed with lighter woods. I don't want to paint it. I really am missing the dark wood colors, even black. So I'm going to leave it. I'm not touching it. But this is what we're going to start with. Now let's build a focal point. All right, this is what we're working with. We've got our table right there. And we've got probably 9-10 foot ceilings, and then they vault upwards. So I don't even know how tall these ceilings are, but anyway, we need to add some height here. Why? Because we can. And this is sort of what the table looks like before we get started. All right, guys, what we're gonna start with is this huge metal wall gate. It's huge. I got this from Ross. Ross of all places, back in the day, it was about $49. This is super heavy. It's really heavy, and you can hang it on the wall, but usually I don't. I usually just lean it, and that is what we're gonna do right here. So let's go place it. Let's lean it up against the wall, shall we? Let's add some texture. So I'm hoping you guys can see, this is now my focal point. So you see the pretty table, and this draws your eyes up. This is going to be another focal point. It's also going to act as adding some pretty texture. You can see how tall this wall gate is because there's the ceiling and it's pretty tall. But this really does draw your eye upward, and now we'll add the wreath to add, you know, a hint of texture. So if you have a wreath, and this is just a little tip, if you're new to my channel and you haven't heard me talk about this tip, get yourself a curtain clip. These are awesome for wreath hangings, and you can just clip it onto the grapevine wreath, and for these metal wall embellishments, it works like a charm. But actually I must have made this before I came up with this idea, because I've had this wreath for years. I'm gonna simply hang it by this. Now, some of you may be thinking, where are you gonna hang that exactly? I'm gonna go shoot for, oops, you can't see. Right here, because I want it to hang, I want to be able to see the doorknobs. So let's see if I can do this. Works like a charm every time. And this is how it looks. Oh, and the sunshine is coming out. Thank you, Jesus. So now I would like to build a beautiful centerpiece that will act as my focal point on the table. And I believe I'm gonna put it center stage, but you never know with me. Once I start playing, I might move things around. But in my head right now, that's what I'm thinking. Here's the gate, here's the wreath, and I want my centerpiece to be right here. And then we'll put a lamp over here and we'll build on that. It's still coming to me. Many of you know my fellow YouTube creator and friend, Bella with Bella D Designs. She is an amazing decorator. So if you're looking for number one home decor inspiration, head on over. I will link her in the description box below. You will not be disappointed. She's a ray of sunshine. If you're ever having a down day, go head on over. She will brighten your day, no joke. But in addition to being a YouTube creator, she also owns her own home decor business where she sells and makes custom wood products for the home. And she's very talented. Her products are wonderful and unique, one-of-a-kind products. So today I'm gonna showcase one of her newer products that she launched. I think it was like a couple weeks ago. These are mini home decor drawer boxes. They're antiqued with beautiful hardware on them. And I'm gonna link the video below where she showcases how you can decorate these a multitude of different ways to give you ideas. Because when I first saw them, I thought, now how would you decorate something like that? I mean, I had a few ideas, but when you see what she does, you'll go, the light bulb will go on and you'll say, I need to have one of those. Those are adorable. But anyway, I got the gray set. She has two different versions, the white set and the gray set. The large one is $24.99. The smaller one is $19.99 and it's free shipping. Now, keep in mind, these are custom made. Her products are made in North America. They're non-toxic. They're completely safe to have in your home and they're gorgeous. So anyway, with that said, again, I'm gonna link everything down below so you can run over there, check it out, or stop by her channel, say hello. And let's decorate this and make a beautiful vignette for my table. This vignette that I want to create, I want it to be more old world Tuscan farmhouse kind of look and feel. So that's where we're heading. So I ran down to my basement storage room and I found this beautiful tray. And I said to myself, bingo, that's going to be my focal point that's going to house my beautiful decor drawers, and I'm gonna build a beautiful vignette in this tray. While I was down in the storage room, I found this. This was one piece. I snipped it into a bunch of little pieces, and I thought, hey, that might mimic like grass, perfect for Easter and spring. So I thought what I would do is layer all of these pieces in here and then build on that. So I'm gonna set this tray down. I'm gonna lift this up so you can watch what I'm gonna do. So before I start layering in all of this, I wanted to find a way to elevate this. So let's see, how am I gonna do this? I found this in my storage room. It's got the white and gray, it's distressed. And I'm gonna place this decor, you know, mini drawer on top of it. I'm gonna stick it right here, like that. And I think I'm gonna start layering in these little pieces. And I want it to kind of cascade off the side. As my layered base, it's all down. Now I'm gonna take this mini decor drawer and I'm gonna sit it at an angle right here on top of the tray. Just like that. I might scoop this over just a little. Perfect. That's the start of my vignette. Now you guys may remember I got these cute napkins from Home Goods, and I thought it's perfect for spring. I could kind of put it in here off and kind of have it cascade off the side just to add a little visual interest. Let me see how I want to do this. Now I need to elevate my bunny. So I found this wood box in the basement, and I'm just gonna set it in here just like that. Just like that. And then I've got like a styrofoam thing. I'm gonna use it as a riser so I can elevate that bunny as best as possible. Now, before I put in Mr. Bunny, I found this in my basement and I thought, I wonder if it'll fit in this little decor box. So let's try it. And it fits perfectly. And I'm just gonna sit it right back on the candle. Not candle. I think of that as a candle holder, but it's just like a little vase. Silly Liz, silly Liz. Okay, let's add the bunny. The bunny we're gonna be adding is from Hobby Lobby. It was $19.99, 40% off in their spring shop. But what I liked about it is it matches the gray color, you know, very well. So anyway, I'm gonna set the bunny right here, just like that. Now I'm doing this on a wobbly little table, so I'm gonna go take it over where I plan to put it so it doesn't fall over. Because I'm not done creating that vignette, I wanna go ahead and add my lights so I don't start knocking things over. Let me go grab that lamp. If you like Tuscan, old world decor like I do, and you wanna try to lighten it up, this is a good way to do it. I've got a dark wood table, I've got the black wall gate. Now I'm adding in a lighter piece. So if you wanna do Tuscan, but you wanna make it more modern looking, add lighter pieces to it, just a tip. I hope you can kinda see that that definitely made a difference with this dark wood table, just adding a lighter piece. But I wanna elevate that lamp, so I'm gonna go get myself some book boxes. Old world looking book boxes, Ross. So another thing I wanna show you, this is actually gonna go on the second shelf, but like I said, I wanna place my lighting and then work everything around it. These are awesome. These are so awesome. I got these at Ross. They're basically big candle holders, but if you think about luminaries, how beautiful they are. This is kind of where I went with this idea. I went to Walmart and I got these little tiny LED lights. So look how tiny these little LED lights are. They're really, really tiny, but I love them. And anyway, I put them in the cans and look how pretty it looks. I absolutely love it, especially if you're going for an old world sort of Tuscan look, but you're trying to modernize, you know, your area. So anyway, these are gonna go on this shelf right there. And I'm all about illuminating my vignettes. I really think it gives it a cozy factor. I don't know, I just love it. I've decided to put these on the opposite side of the other where I put the lamp. I put the lamp over up top that way. So I'm coming down here to the right. This is what we have so far. And then moving over here is the tray with the cute mini decor drawers. Now let's build a vignette. Let's add the bunny. Just like that. So I have different greenery pieces. My favorite from Hobby Lobby. I've got some wispy ones and some yellow tip ones. Yeah, so I'm just gonna start filling this box with greenery. So now I want to add just a few pops of yellow. And so I've got 1, 2, I don't know, 4 little stems of yellow. And I thought I would place those in amongst the greenery to add, you know, more texture, a more textural element. So I love the color of this. It's this beautiful amber color, but I like how it looks with this. And I don't know if you guys can see the those canisters down there. It looks beautiful with that too. I think it looks very rich and elegant, those, you know, the color combination. Now here's the smaller version. I'm just gonna sit it right beside the larger one. I have to say, I am really, really loving the top of this. And it just goes to show you can mix and match decor styles. So although I have a more traditional piece of furniture in darker wood, you know, I've added an old world gate that I've just leaned against the wall. I've lightened it up by adding this light wreath and the lighter lamp. And then I've got these two mini decor drawers that are kind of farmhouse, old world looking. And then I've built a beautiful vignette around it. I love the tray because the tray ties in with this and this. And I love the reflective properties of the glass. I think it kind of gives it more of an elegant look. Now on the second shelf, we've got those canisters with the LED lights in them. To the side of that, I'm gonna add this ivy plant and a bunny and a plate. Now I've got this cute little bunny plate from Hobby Lobby, and I'm just gonna set it right there. Next to it, I've got this cute little bunny, and I'm just gonna snug it right there. And then I've got this little rustic element, and I'm just gonna set that right there. Now on the bottom shelf, I've got this simple tray and just a bunch of garden balls. I decided to take that away and just keep it simple. Now, because I have greenery right here, I'm gonna come diagonal and put my garden balls, and I'm gonna angle them just like that. Now, I do have this wire basket full of moss balls, and it's kind of rustic, so it sort of ties in with the gray up there, if you can see that, and you know, the lamp. So I thought I could just put this right down here and then add one more bunny beside it. So one cute idea I have is to add some ribbon around Mr. Bunny's neck. So I got some scissors and I'm gonna put a little bow around his neck. Let's see how it looks. He looks rather dapper. I like it. I think it's cute. Now, because I have so much wall space on either side of this table, I decided to add two chairs. Now, because I can't get out to shop, I'm using what I have, the pillows that match my comforter set. So I just put one there and one there. That I'm sure will change. But, if and when I can get out to shop, I would like to get two big, beautiful lanterns with candle sconces on either side of this wall gate, and I think that will complete the look. I hope you enjoyed it. At least, you know, seeing my vision on how I create a focal point, how I do my vignettes, on a table, how I illuminate my vignettes, and trying to add a cozy factor, a cozy display, if you will. And you can do this through the seasons. So anyway, please go check out my friend Bella at Bella D Designs, and I'll link her home decor store down in the description box below. You can go see all of her home decor products. So without further ado, I just want to say I love you guys. Thank you for your love, your support, your sweet comments. Stay safe, wash those hands, peeps, and enjoy your time as a family. Make memories, laugh, you know, come together. That's what we can do, and pray, and pray. All right, guys, love you so much. Mwah. Bye, guys.